And we welcome you back to the NASCAR 2004 Let's Play Season 2. You're going to be at Texas Motor Speedway today for the running new Samsung RadioShack 500. So, last week at Bristol, Jimmy Johnson finally won, so giving Hendrick Motorsports its first win in a season that's been predominantly won by me and Dale Jarrett. We are still the points leader by over Dale Earnhardt Jr., so this image. The scheme we're going to run is the inverted paint scheme. Let's jump right in.
Jump right into this, fam.
Opened in 1997, Texas Motor Speedway was one of the fastest racetracks on that fastest intermediate racetracks of the NASCAR circuit, as demonstrated by what my initial speed on this qualifying lap, flying in turn 3 at a good 191 miles an hour. Coming off turn 4, coming to the start-finish line, you're going to want to keep your car as close to the bottom as you can, as demonstrated by my 29.51 lap. Your car will want to push up, but probably one of the more faster ways around, even though Texas is a multi-groove racetrack, is either right on the bottom or on the top. As I dive down into 3, I'm going to keep the car as close as I can to the bottom of the racetrack. Your car may hit the apron, but unlike NASCAR 2005, don't worry about it. You come to the line, and our lap was...
Second lap was faster by, like, this much. Holy shit.
Okay. Kevin Harvick and Kurt Busch are on the front row. Here's PRI.
Welcome to Texas Motor Speedway in Fort Worth, Texas, and today's NASCAR Winston Cup race, the Samsung RadioShack 500. Tell us about this track.
Texas is a tough track for these drivers to get a hang of. It's very fast, but has a very tight groove. Some of these cars may add some paint to the walls here before the race is over.
Kevin Harvick will start this race with the all-important points lead.
FYI, all these rivals are from Bristol.
I just try to stay focused on getting the best finish I can. After all, consistency is what wins the championship.
Bobby Labonte is in the top 5 in points so far this season.
Gaining on the leader is tough when you're in the top 5 in points. It takes you having a good race and the leader having a bad one in order to gain anything substantial.
Jack Spray really needs a good finish in this race. He's got a long way to go on the points list.
Yeah, those guys have been working so hard this year. It's a shame it really doesn't show in the points. Just seems they can't keep that car out of trouble on race day. And maybe their luck will change today.
All right. The patriotic flyover. Let's take a look at your top 10 in the starting line. Jeff Gordon finally has a decent starting spot. Let's see if there's any alternates in this field. Mike Skinner has one, and that was his 2002 Pontiac car.
In the second row are the Stagger 2 Dodge and the Lowe Chevrolet. Starting the race from row 3 are the Home Depot Chevrolet and the UPS 4. The fourth row has the Altel Dodge and the DeWalt Power Tools 4. Starting the race from row 5 will be the M&M's 4 and the Interstate Federation.
We come into this race as the points leader over the 8th of Dale Earnhardt Jr., who starts 14th this afternoon here in the Samsung RadioShack 500. As you can probably see in a few moments, Texas is one of my better racetracks on this game. Anyways, those rivals that were listed in the pre-race were almost all from Bristol. This will be pretty interesting. Green flag into the air at Texas. Whoa, Dale Jarrett got in the wall coming off turn two. Really kind of bottlenecked everyone. The caution is not out. Kurt Busch, however, is going to take his 97 Rubbermaid Ford off turn four. Lead lap number one. Jimmy Johnson is in second. We are in third. So far, two laps in, it is already a four-car breakaway between me, Kurt Busch, Jimmy Johnson, Tony Stewart, and I. Because we're all damn sure on the bottom, but here comes Johnson looking to the inside. We're going to look to the inside of Johnson, get the spot away from him. Now we got Kurt Busch. We do get a little squirrely with him, pass him on the inside, and we're going to fly to the lead with a really big run. Here comes Johnson coming back on the inside, though. Throw the block on him. Four laps complete here in the Samsung RadioShack 500 is so far me, Jimmy Johnson, and Kurt Busch continue to fight for spots. Fight for the lead. Kurt seems to have the best line. Wow, look at this. Kurt tries to get to the inside. We're going to shut the door on the 97 car and continue to lead here at Texas. Coming off of turn two. How about that truck race Friday night, guys? Holy cow. I like the idea of segments, but do it at certain tracks. Segments in a big track like Daytona, and especially the Camping World Truck Series, has basically become the ARCA Truck Series of NASCAR. It's really good, just a matter of time before a freak accident happens that's out of their control. The next thing you know, NASCAR's got a hurt driver on their hands or worse. I mean, I'm talking about this. You guys know the wreck I'm talking about, which was on the last lap. Matt Crafton flipped in something that was seen straight out of NASCAR 08. Or, if even better, for you newer millennials who don't know the meaning of good nostalgia, NASCAR Heat Evolution for the Xbox One. It's stupid, honestly. It's just a matter of time with this segment crap before they kill someone. It was like with the caution clock last year. It was perfect. I mean, everybody knew how to play this, be conservative. Sure, wrecks were going to happen, but the only freak wreck that kind of freaked me out with last year was when the four of Christopher Bell flipped on the last lap. I actually was really nervous for the Xfinity race that day, the next day, and the Daytona 500 on Sunday. Whereas last year, I kind of wasn't. Another lap led for the 29 of Kevin Harvick as we continue to pull away from the 20 of Tony Stewart and the 97 of Kurt Busch. We're a little over under a second and a half on the 20. You know, let's go on more the GM Goodrich Chevrolet. Very rarely do you let off the gas in the corners at Texas Motor Speedway. You are literally... You're screaming around this racetrack. Oh, Jesus. And the only time you let off is if you smack the wall like I did. Like an idiot. Stewart Stewart really closed in that time. He lost a good... Newman has taken the fourth spot. Dale Jarrett has climbed to fifth. It just looks like Matt Kenseth is in the sixth. See the bright yellow in the black car. Another lap led by the 29 of Kevin Harvick. Looks like Newman, Kurt Busch, and Tony Stewart all continue to fight for second. Newman slides up to cover the spot. So we fly on to turns 3 and 4. It won't last, but yet I'll be stupid enough to try two tires at this track. We have a second and a half over the 12 car of Ryan Newman. This may or may not work. So far in the Samsung RadioShack 500, we have spent an uneventful, except for that slight scare where I smacked the wall, and I'm still able to lead this thing. I'm a freaking legend, fam. Another lap led, and now we're almost 2 seconds away from the 12. Yes, and by the way, the car that did get into fifth was indeed the 17 of Kenseth. At least it wasn't like the NASCAR weight race at Texas, where all I did was, which by the way, you can see that on my channel since it was up Friday afternoon. Even to see me leading all these laps and just pulling away, but compared to NASCAR 08, which is on the PS3, around this time I would start catch lap traffic. Here I'm just barely under 2.5, barely at 2.5 seconds on the 12 of Newman. As we continue to rush through turn 4. Another lap led, as you see Kurt Busch was one of the drivers that came in that time. FYI, this time by, we will pit as we come down the back stretch. As we're gone right now. Who's in second? Kurt Busch is second. Jeff Gordon has made his way to third. Come on the line. No. Come on. Full stop. Good stop, boys. Alright, good quick stop. Alright, good stop. Great stop, boys. Drive this baby. And look who comes out right behind us, the 24 car, Jeff Gordon. Let him get the spot. Give him as much room as possible. Now we're clear. There's the 88 of Dale Jarrett right there. I'm assuming he is parked. Not sure if he's pitted or not. Oh, we got a slow car right here. Apparently we heard there was a slow car. I'm not sure. We do have cars entering pit road. Trying to duck and dive. Now it's just going to be a case of if I catch these guys or not on these new tires and fuel. You see the 01 of Jerry Nadeau coming down pit road. There's a group of four cars. See the 17 of Kenseth, 12 of Newman, Brian Newman, 97 of Kurt Busch, and the 24 car Jeff Gordon. Try to get some draft off him. And I mean, we closed in pretty good that time. Daddy likey. Wow, we're really closing in on these guys that time. We're now up to sixth. When we come around to the start-finish line, when pit cycles cycle all around, it'll be Kurt Busch leading this race. Just like on NASCAR 2005 at Texas, how was case of five cars going for the win? It very well is the case, looks to be the case right now. Kurt Busch leads here at Texas. Slow car on the bottom, that is the 30 of Steve Park. Gordon gets freight trained all the way to the outside of this group. We get by the 12 of Ryan Newman. Now it's going to be a battle between the Roush cars, the 29 of Harvick, 24 of Gordon, and the 12 of Newman. All the way to the outside lane goes Harvick. But this won't work. We're going to cross low. That was almost... Whoa! Passing the grass right there. 11 laps to go. Contact down towards turn 1. Here comes Kurt Busch back on the low side. Kenseth gets into the wall. There goes the other two cars. Look at that. Side by side for the lead as they come off turn 4. Whoa, contact is made. And lots of it. Tony Stewart exiting pit road ahead. He is one of the drivers a lap down. How we almost had a situation just like Atlanta Motor Speedway, where down in Atlanta, where we basically almost lost this race just from a very similar situation. There's Kurt Busch down in turn 2. Gordon in second. Whoa, tight. Newman to the inside of Gordon to take second. 3 wide at the line. All the way to second. Oh my god. Now we gotta run down that 97 car. Eight laps to go. Some cars did get together at the back of this group. Looks like Gordon got into the 12 of Newman. Right there. Never mind. Look at me passing the grass right there. Really gaining on these guys right now. Through turns 1 and 2. I'm following in a similar line that Kurt Busch is, but in that wall, kind of let him pull away. So they come off turn 4 again. Now we've closed the lead to just a little over a second. This is looking to be a pretty good Texas two-step right here. Down the back stretch. We're really closing in on that 97 car. Here we go. This could be a good Texas-sized duel this afternoon. This Tuesday afternoon. Here we go. 4 laps of racing, 5 to go here at Texas. And just like that, we've caught up to that 97. Kurt's into the wall. Well, good thing there's Talladega next week, because I think I just pissed off Kurt Busch, which is not a good idea. Four to go. I'm into the line, side by side. Contact, big contact that time. Contact there.
Oh, this is going to get good.
Between these two cars. This could get good. Don't leave that bottom open. Kurt can't really get that one, but we really got loose that time. Kurt barely leads this lap. Three laps to go. Could be dead even right here. All the way to the outside. Kurt throws the block. And Kurt gets into the wall this time. More contact in the tri-oval. And Kurt Busch just fell out of contention after getting loose in the tri-oval. Two laps to go at Texas. And Kurt Busch is still in second, but no opportunity to get that win. Unless I wreck. Coming to the line, white flag into the air here at Texas. Thank the Lord we have Talladega next week. Down the backstretch we go for the final time. Stanton Barrett, who is a lap down, he won't be a factor. Neither will be Kurt Busch as we come off of turn four into the checkered flag. Kevin Harvick wins in an exciting duel at Texas. Kenseth was able to get second. How about that? How about that? Great job. Briefly an exciting win, or race for the win. I mean, shit, if that wasn't that lap where I got into Kurt wasn't the last lap, Kurt probably would have won it. Gonna cruise. Can't park.
A rare caution free race.
Watch this.
News for all these teams, because that can mean only one thing: no major wrecks.
Kevin get loose.
Comes away with the win.
Well, I kind of get Kurt here.
This one, great car, great team, and oh yeah, a great driver too.
The 29 car has begun a new rivalry on the racetrack.
Well, when you're out there beating and banging on guys, some feathers are bound to get ruffled. Maybe after some time to cool off, they'll be back.
Oh wow! Right there. You couldn't tell from that angle if I came down on Kurt or Kurt came down on me. But at that point, when Kurt got that wall, he was done. We'll let you guys be the judge right here when that reel came around where we were coming out of the quad oval. There we were, side by side. I couldn't hold it up top. I got into Kurt. That one I'll probably say was my fault, because I probably shouldn't have been down on the bottom. Wow, that right there was probably what pissed him off. Here we go. We're both on the bottom. Okay, right here. Watch right here. So we're coming to the line. Right here. They're dead even. Yeah, Kurt came down, I think.
I think Kurt came down on that bit.
You guys, tell me if I'm wrong, but I think Kurt came down. That was, what you call, that was almost a pretty good Texas duel. Sucked it couldn't. Sucked the race was longer, otherwise it would have been a pretty epic duel to the finish when you think about it. Minus 70 for Kurt Busch, minus 60 for Mark Martin, none for Jimmy Johnson, and plus 18 for Ryan Newman. And we got the Texas Road Course.
I'm pretty sure Kurt Busch is probably listening to this Sunday night after the race.
Here, let's turn it up. Okay, anyways, after that brief space cadet moment, Kevin Harvick wins today at Texas, Matt Kenseth finishes second, Kurt Busch third, Ryan Newman fourth, Jimmy Johnson fifth, Sterling Marlin sixth, Rusty Wallace seventh, Dale Earnhardt Jr. eighth, Jeff Gordon ninth, and Bobby Labonte tenth. Only car that fouled the race was Steve Park. Tony Stewart was struggling. For some reason, he pit twice. And here's the rest of the field. Alright. Look. Okay, see how the points shake out. 264 points over the 8 of Dale Jr. Kurt Busch and Jr. are actually tied in points. Bobby Labonte is in 4th, 324 back. Michael Walsh is 5th, 335 back. Sterling Marlin 6th in points, 348 back. Jimmy Johnson 7th in points, 354 back. Ricky Craven 8th in points, 368 points back. Ryan Newman is 9th in points, 384 back. Dale Jarrett is 10th in points, 385 back. Matt Kenseth is 11th, also 385 back. Jeff Burton is 12th in points, 401 back. Ricky Rudd is 429 points back in 13th. Rusty Wallace is 437 points back in 14th. Mark Martin's 441 points back in 15th. Bill Elliott is 6th in points, 445 points back. Jeff Gordon is 17th in points, 481 points back. Ward Burton is 18th, 532 back. Tony Stewart is 19th, 546 back, and Jared Nader was 20th in points, 551 back. Next time, we're going
to... Next race, which will actually be the first double... Next time, first doubleheader episode of this Let's Play, we'll be at Talladega Super Speedway for race 8 of 36 for the Run 80 Aaron's 499. See you next time.